I'm gonna do a video about David Bowie today. Sorry, my voice is a bit scrambled there. Okay, just like... So I just pick up, like, I'm aware that he had like a property in the Caribbean. So I just feel like whether he's like still in the flesh or his spirit has decided to like hang out there. I feel like his strong presence there. And it's sort of quiet and peaceful. I mean, if he's still alive, like he doesn't like go a lot of places, like but where he is very nice. Like, I'm not getting a lot of like. Okay, I'm just gonna sort of see if I see any like, did he pass away stuff. I'm not getting I'm not getting like death picture stuff. It feels more like a stressful environment where his feet very quiet, and then there's like a shuttle, like a movement of him. Like, I don't know, it just feels like sorry, my dog's playing with his toy. I feel like if, let's say he's let's say he's still alive and like not like hiding out but like laying low. Like in the Caribbean or something. Like let's say oh my gosh. Dr. Disco, come. Come here. Okay, I just have to like tap him gently on his shoulder to make him stop barking at it. Yeah, anyhow, so however, okay. Let's say he's like in a hospital setting or like a place that does like a hospice, is that what it's called? Like when you're a person's like dying. So I feel like it was like he was in like a place like that that didn't have like a massive population or something, and then there was like the gesture of like okay he's gone, but then like like getting in a car and like going somewhere else. I don't know. Like so I get the word taxes. I don't know if they're really, I don't know if he owed taxes or, I don't know. Sorry, I just asked for this. I'm just gonna tell you what I pick up and try not to judge what I pick up, because like, all right, I don't know. I feel like there was pressure on him within, like from his wife and stuff, to take a certain route, like to make a decision. And you know, it's like it's nice and everything to have like a partner in life and stuff, but like often they have like their free will is like different than yours and stuff, and so I kind of feel like he would have done something different. Like, I don't know, like He might have like retired to England or like, I don't know, like they maybe had different ideals about old age, like what to do and stuff. Oh my gosh, come here, come here. If he does that again, I'll pause the video. Okay, just one second. Because like this video has been really chaotic and I've been having to move around a lot, like dealing with the dog, I kind of feel like there might be some aspect of that where he's like having to move from here to there, like with some like frequency and like suddenness and stuff. I kind of feel like let's say if he's like decided to like retreat from society for whatever reasons, whether it was like for his marriage or like it was just a decision that was made, I feel like he's not happy with that decision. It's not like authentic to him. Like he's more like a face the music kind of guy, and like, you know, any situation could be like turned into something good or like he's just like more in the moment and chill about stuff. And like when you connect with certain like close friends or a partner, like things can just go south pretty quickly if you aren't authentic. Just one second. Okay, let me just try to get back into it. I mean, I think there, like, let's say hypothetically, like if his wife was like, do this for your daughter, like spend more time with us, whatever, I just kind of feel like it ended up putting more strain on things and whatever perceived dangers or nuisances that his wife kind of felt existed in their normal life before they made this decision, like weren't really that threatening. And like maybe it was like a bit of fear mongering or I don't know, just like, don't get mad, I'm just like telling you what I'm picking up. It's and I'm just getting like this feeling of like money, like before I got the word like taxes or like, so maybe like the coincidence of his like passing and like the release of his album, like in generating sales, and like I just don't feel like that was his idea, and it was like to satisfy some, like maybe his wife likes to live well, or I don't know, and like maybe they didn't have like as much as they wanted at that time, or I don't know. And I get this like happy picture of him like in England, like in the countryside, like somewhere northwest of London, like closer to the seaside, just having fun with like friends or okay, all right. Yeah, I just get this like Like, I know, like, marriage can be nice, or what, like, if you're, like, on board and you're doing some important project, like, let's build stability, let's build a family, but then, like, there's the nitty-gritty of, like, do we get along, and, like, just how to make things, like, nice, like, throughout. So I just feel like a lot of people are messy within that, and they like can develop toxic habits over time of like being overly critical, or like just keeping the vibe low in the household. And like, so I just kind of feel like David Bowie, like as a person, is very like sweet and lighthearted, and is very good at like keeping things on like going on an upward trajectory. And then I just feel like there's people who like dating famous people and getting luxuries and security from that, and like they use their charm and beauty and say like persuasive things to like get to meet their needs and stuff like that. So I just kind of feel like this intersection of that kind of thing of like him just being this like creative spirit, and then like other people just going like, okay, I'm gonna like, it's like you're gonna put reins on a wild horse and like and go around town going like, isn't this great that I got this wild horse to take me around, like that kind of thing. So I just sort of feel like, you gotta date someone, right? But like anyway, it's just, I just don't feel like this is an ideal pairing, because like there's this reining his energy and his finances for her purposes and stuff. Wait, hang on a second. Like, I kind of feel like David Bowie would be happy like living sort of in the country with his buddies and like having a nice little cottage, and he's got like a sunroom and his books, and like he can jam with friends and just kind of like that kind of lifestyle. And then I feel like Iman's vibe is like more like looking awesome, going out, being seen, like having clothing and items that are like of a high quality, and just being like kind of this princess queen vibe, like of just like gliding through life like a yacht cutting through the waters, just on her way, like unstoppable, or I don't know, something like, it's like they have very different energies in that way. Wait. Okay, hang on. Sorry, I'm trying to like train him. How's it going? All right, so I'm just gonna, I don't know if he has like another child that like we don't, like I know he has like his son from his first marriage, right? And then he has a daughter with Iman, but I feel like there's like a younger one too. And then maybe this other child is like in England or something. Okay. Like it feels like a girl. Maybe it was about like saving face for his second wife, like to not reveal like this new family that he has or something. I don't know. Okay, let's see all the details. Yeah, so I feel like her interaction with him, like, I hesitate to say her name for some reason, but anyway, his second wife isn't like that smooth or like So I don't really like get some clear messages here. Yeah, I just feel like if he's, let's say he's, no, you don't need to bark at me. Okay. Sweetheart, do you want to come up? Okay, just 1 second. We're gonna try to get through this video. Oh my gosh. Okay, no. Shh. Just 1 second. Alright. I just have to like sort of just say like I'm not getting a big like he died picture. I'm getting more of like trying to live quietly in a couple of locations and stuff. And that he's not making like a lot of movement, like he's and it's sad to me, like, when I pick up this vibe, like, what people consider to be love can sometimes be, like, trapping a bird in a cage. And that's not love, like, you know, like, was it Sting? Or is this, if you love somebody, set them free. It's that kind of thing, like, you have to think of it like you went into a forest and you saw like a stag and it was cool to like have that encounter with nature, and then like maybe at some point the stag gets spooked after staring at you for a while, and then let's say you go back to that forest and then like it's up to the stag whether they choose to like come and stare at you again or eat grass near you. And like, do they get spooked or do they slowly become your friend or whatever? But like, some people are just like, oh, I got something good, like I'm not letting it go and I'm gonna do what I can to like manipulate the situation to working to my advantage, which I think is their advantage because I'm so great. And like, like all those things you can say to convince yourself you're doing the right thing. So I just kind of feel like there's a bit of a toxic, like, narcissistic type of relationship going on there with him. But I feel like he's not the narcissist in this case. But someone who's like loving and doesn't want to like no, you can't do that. Okay, wait just a sec. Yeah, like I said before, he has like this playful, childlike discovery energy, and that's what like that's why he was able to make the career that he made, because he's just like going through life, making it fantastical and fun along the way. And then, like, what starts out is just like, oh, like, I've, you know, stumbled upon this wonderful person, and what a joyful experience this is, and then, like, that, and then, like, you realize, like, oh, this person is building, like, this cinder block square around me, and I can't get out. And it's different than when you first met, like, let's say they first met, and she was just, like, easy breezy, maybe seeing somebody else, and, like, you know, just like that environment seemed approachable to him because it wasn't like so serious. And then like at some point he's like, oh shit, like I'm in something now and there's, I can't get out. Like, and then making some philosophical like rationales why it's good that he's trapped or like, you know, stuff like that. So I think like, Okay, let's say, for example, if he were to like, let's say he's in hiding and he comes out of hiding, and then it's like this discussion about like toxic relationships or like, I need to be authentic and I did this because I thought it was best for the situation and whatever. And then it's like a good example for people to like consider what is really like proper love and things like that. Kind of like with the Johnny Depp and Amber Heard thing, it's like you can spend all day laughing or criticizing this or that aspect of it, but it's just like a community discussion really about like how to act in a relationship, how to not. Like, if you see red flags, just get out of there. Like, stuff like that. Just like reminders to people about, like, we're all growing up together, watching each other, experiencing things, like, comparing notes, whatever. And so, like, for in this case, here's someone who really thrives on freedom. And that's not a bad thing, it's just who they are. And then there's someone who's, like, likes to lock stuff down, who's with them. And maybe they're both great people. I'm not saying like neither of them are great, excellent, like interesting, worthwhile people, but like together, are they like causing more harm than good? Like, kind of thing. So just something to think about, because like we're evolving as people and relationship styles will evolve. Levels of respect and free will evolve too. So, like, what are the choices we make now in like 2022 will seem antiquated in like 15 years or 12 years. So, it's like, it's okay to look at this stuff and point things out. So I'm just trying to see like themes about David Bowie's life and purpose and stuff. And I kind of feel like part of his purpose is to underline this sense of like, let me be me, like let me go on my journey of discovery and creativity without people feeling the need to like grab it for themselves or. And it's okay to have three kids along the way with three different people, if that's how things roll. Okay, come here. What? Just like. I'll try to wrap this up because like my dog is being a little rascal. Okay. Yeah, and I get this theme of like drug use and stuff. And I feel like it's more pointed to like a certain time in his life. Like it was like a 15-year period of time when he was like using drugs. Like I know like in the like during his Berlin years or whatever. I don't know every detail about him, but like I'm aware that he went through like a phase where he used drugs and stuff. Yeah, and I just sort of feel like he like whatever flower he wanted to creatively wanted to create at that time seemed kind of dull. Like he sort of I think regretted going so hard down that path and his expression, like his gifts to the world were like kind of muddied by like the drugs sort of softening his message or just it being like less clear or like it was he regrets that. And it's kind of that thing of like this theme again of like the people closest to you, like the people you love take you can be manipulative and stuff. And I know that like I think like ages ago I read his first wife's autobiography, but it was like really long time ago, like over 30 years ago. So I don't recall everything, but like it was kind of like he was like the clay that she was molding. I'll take you for a walk after this. So it seems like throughout his life he had these people who like were like, oh, like look at this sparkle of life, like I'm gonna sort of trap it, like I'm trapping Tinkerbell in my hands, and like we're gonna do this, that, and the other thing. But like people don't know how to treat these wonderful people, and like you don't have to own them and you don't have to harness them and stuff like that. Okay, you need to stop being aggressive. But he was doing so well with training yesterday. I was watching the Caesar like videos, but today he's like doing that. This is the guy that will not let me do the video. Okay, so just try to wrap up this too long David Bowie video. Yeah, so I like to look at people's life purpose, their challenges, their like optimistic, wonderful message, whatever. So like I feel kind of like his one of his like his main message is like, do you, like be you, if you happen to like fall in love with or like have a best friend of me or someone who wants to like rein you in, lovingly separate and keep doing your thing, because like your relationship with, like I'm gonna say, like describe it like this, like your relationship with God or like your intuition or your creative spark that's like giving you life inside is like that your main relationship, you know. It's kind of like how, like, I mean, I don't know everything about religion at all, but like let's say it's like how nuns are like married to Jesus, or I think that's who they marry, and like Christian ones, and then they like live their life out doing like good deeds or meditating or you know keeping the vibe high or whatever nuns do and stuff, and so it's kind of the same thing, like even though everybody's not like a nun, but like it's like your main relationship is like spiritual, and then you're like living in the world. So you have to be conscious of not like just like squashing that spiritual priority so that you can like appear normal in like real life, and like you could argue that real life is actually like all of you, which is your spirit too, living on earth. So like you don't wanna sacrifice your true identity to make someone quote unquote happy, and if their happiness equals your like being kind of enslaved to them and whatever they're trying to build, or the illusions they have of themselves, or their illusions of like what is a relationship. You know, because sometimes like you can be married to someone for like 35 years. You can also meet someone for 2 hours, like at a train station, and like you can always like remember that person that was fleeting, like and value it maybe even more than someone you like, you know, chained yourself to for decades. And the reason why it was like real and true is because like neither of you was trying to trap each other and stuff. So I'm not saying like don't get married or build stability with someone. Like do that if it feels like authentic to you and you're excited about it and you feel like it's like your true calling that is like your own idea and it wasn't given to you by a person. Yeah, because I feel like he really struggled with like, well, what is a friend? Like, what is a wife? Like, what you know, and how is this in line with me and my purpose? If you think of him like an earth angel who came down to just like add some fun and sparkle and creativity to our world, like why would you want to treat like an earth angel like just a regular guy and like lock him down into a marriage and stuff? Like wouldn't you want him to just be like spreading joy and love and laughter around the world like as he wants, you know? Because he's not meant to just make one person happy. Yeah, so it's a bit of a, like, his example would be, like, a lesson. And if he's still alive somewhere, I would encourage him to, I don't know if he remembers meeting me in the elevator in Montreal during that snowstorm in 2006. But, like, I would just encourage him to forgive himself for whatever choices he made, and just come back into life and just talk about it if he's still around. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this reading.